Check, please. So that's who created her. Ah, hello everyone. Next video, as promised, is Chicken Run, Dawn of the Nugget. The sequel to Chicken Run that came out 23 years ago. A movie that was produced by Armin Animations. And to be good news and bad news, the bad news is Mel Gibson's voice actor who played as Rocky, he's not in it, unfortunately, along with the one who played as our dear friend Ginger. But at least Zachary Levi came into the mix, so it's not as if it's a complete disaster, even though we don't have the full group. And even if this woman is not a perfect Ginger, like, maybe... But at least she's very good, at least. But the extra good news is we found out the character who played as Molly, that's Ginger and Rocky's kid, is played by Bella Ramsey, the one who did Game of Thrones, his Dark Materials, and The Last of Us live action, who she played as Ellie, which I thought she did pretty well, despite the setbacks. And we'd still get our original crew members, like Amanda. I can't spell her name out properly, but I definitely know who she worked as characters. It's our dear buddy who played as Bunty. The red chicken, and a former egg layer champion, because she laid 5 eggs this morning. 5! Now that's a bloody record, if I do say so myself. Let's see. This Mac is also actress is still in town. Lynn Bergson, Scottish Nerdy Chicken, who is Ginger's assistant, which is basically a right-hand woman, if you want to put that in the mix. And let's see. Jane Holrocks. I remember her. She was the one who was in Roald Dahl's Witches, which, honestly, I think I prefer that movie from the book, because it actually gives a more happy ending than most. Don't get me wrong, they still got the main pieces in. They couldn't scrape that. But alas, I'm getting ahead of myself. She played as Babs before, and even this year. Dim-witted chicken who is adept at knitting. Hey, that's like saying the same thing about Lenny. There's more to her head to just air, you know. And if she knows how to knit, then I think that could be useful. Dimwitted. Jesus, I'll give him a dimwit. David Brynlin, who played as Fowler, an elderly rooster and a former RAF mascot, which is the Royal Air Force, is what? Which, he replaced the original one who did it, did Fowler. I'm sure he would be proud of Dave's work. And truth be told, I trust that man with my life just as much as anyone. So, And finally, since we already saw the trailer, I might as well throw it out in the open. Matilda Richardson, who played as Mrs. Melissa Tweedy, the former chicken owner. You remember her? She was in charge of Ginger and the other groups in regards to making the profits from the eggs, and as soon as some of them don't do very well, dead, which, to be fair, I remember Edwina, poor girl, couldn't lay any more eggs. And I still remember what Ginger, Babs' conversation, she wondered why Babs couldn't give her any. But to be honest, she would have. But Edwina never told anybody. I guess she just maybe didn't want to cause a worry or a panic, or maybe she was just tired. I don't know. Either way, sadly, she didn't make it. Still, Mr. Tweedy was a ruthless woman and trying to make a profit out of the chickens one way or the other. I still remember that pie machine. Dastardly machine, it was. So, what's this movie about, since I'm getting ahead of myself? It tells the story of Rocky and Ginger, who leads a rescue mission when their daughter has been abducted to a highly advanced poultry farm run by our dear friend Mrs. Tweedy. Honestly, I'll give you a minor spoiler. The place is a fortress. No different than what you would see from probably during the World War II eras. Maybe even a highly advanced prison camp. The only difference, instead of laying eggs or making pies, this is a processing plant where you can make chickens into pure nuggets. Chicken nuggets or goujons, you name it. Which, to be fair, even though I'm a cannibal on meat, on eating the meat of chickens and beef, you know, doesn't mean I take complete pleasure like a savage, you know, even though it is enjoyable, the food. But at least we have standards to make a balance. Oof, grieve myself out of saying that. To be honest, I can give you an update on Molly. She's just like her mom and dad. Smart, a little stubborn, and definitely a little adventurous and knows how to take some risks. And it's probably no surprise why she got captured. She just wanted to get off the island to explore the world. And to be honest, Mommy didn't want her daughter to go out there. I mean, she was a prisoner, which was no different than what... I think this series was based in something of references to World War II, where of prisoners like the Jews and that, and keeping them under lock and key, tortured, working, you name it. And after they're not abused, they kill you. I still remember the gas chamber incidents. Ugh, I'm not going to get into details, but it was horrible to say the least. But at the end of the day, I understood her reasons, as anyone would. So, what was it? Who was directed by? Ah, Sam Fell, the same man who did it from the first one that 23 years ago, and Henry Gregson-Williams, who also did the Chicken Run as well. X-Men Origins Wolverine, The Lion's Witch in the Wardrobe, Men on Fire, Sinbad and Legends of the Seven Seas, Shrek franchise, Flushed Away. This guy's a Grand Slam record just as much as Williams and the others. Well played, sir. So, my dear friends, honestly, it's not as perfect as the first, but in all honesty, even though there has been changes, a little bit of goof-ups, there was definitely some funny moments, entertaining moments, feeling moments as well that made it all balanced and worth the while. So, is it 10 out of 10? No. But is it as low? No. Which is why I'm going to give it 7 out of 10. Yeah, that seems like a very decent score. And I recommend it to anyone who's still a fan of the old movie. New isn't always bad. Don't get me wrong, you always enjoy the classics of old, but if you don't get out of your comfort zone, You won't be able to see new flowers growing or new opportunities. Now, one more to go, and it's time for what we would call it dessert. Because you got a very bad starter, my apologies. This was the main course. Now for the main dessert. Bye-bye for now.